My friend!
You look, how are you?
How's night in Miami?
It's good.
Girls? It's
good. Yeah, girls.
Cocaine.
Cocaine.
Yeah. Barbells.
Barbells. In that order.
Specific schools, and we pay for the
like
training.
Yeah, you pay to be like a student or
yeah.
whatever.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. In US, you do this just because you want to do this, you like, and maybe you believe that you will find some sponsors.
Do you think that's a good system in the end?
It's much better. And if you do CrossFit, when you have children, you will say, go to weightlifting.
Yeah.
Because 10 years ago, it was like a not so good stereotype that every weightlifter has a short.
Not short, they're short, yeah. I mean, look at me, dude.
You are so short, yeah.
Yeah, I'm short as hell. Hey guys, this is MTV Cribs. Welcome to my island. This is my kitchen area right here. It's a little messy, but this is where I do most of my programming and coaching. Yeah. I also shit here too, so.
You need to start like from the basic. You need to say that I'm shit. I'm like, and I need to start from something very, very light. But don't believe that you're exception, and you need to be like Ilya Ilyin. You need to be like a Klokov. You need to be like
Alexei Tarakti.
So you need to be yourself, but you need to know that you need to start and growing up, and you don't need to. What I try to share that you don't need to copy someone. You need to be yourself. You don't need to copy a technique of another athlete. You should build. You need to build yourself. You need to build your technique, your movement, and it's very funny because my opinion that the program what I have on my website lack strength. It's a stupid program. A lot of people during my seminars asked me about, do you have a legs program? I need to build more power in my legs. And I'm like, first 10 seminars I told that, guys, it's not important, more important your movement. And after 10 seminars I say, okay, I will do, and I will put this on my website. It's your choice. If you want, buy, do, and after this you will compare. When I create my first training program and put this on the internet, it was for free. One guy texted me that's like, Alex, your program is shit. So, he texted that my back squat is 250 kilos. My best clean jerk is 110 kilos. In your program, I need to do 90% 3x3 from my best clean and jerk. It means that I need to do around 95 kilos.
For 3x3?
3x3.
Yeah.
For me, it's just warm up. Because my best is 250 in back squat. If your best clean and jerk is 210,
110
kilos. Back squat 250. It means that you need to stop and forget about back squat forever.
Yeah.
You need to just develop and realize your power in classic exercise. This relationship between power and speed, it's very, very strong in weightlifting. If you stay stronger, you stay slower.
Slower, yes.
If you move your power down, you stay faster.
Yes. If you move your strength down,
yeah,
you get faster.
I mean, that's how it's possible to move the strength down. For example, if you will done your back squat, your pull, you will stay faster. That's why you can be stronger, but you will be so slow.
Yes.
And I think it's enough because we are on an island and it's not good to speak about weightlifting on an island.
Yes. Yes.
On the living dread, in that is the dawn of the living day.
shit different day, dog. With another tall guy who lifts a lot more than me.
Slightly less tall.
Slightly less tall, whatever. It's Marcus. Marcus.
Hi, Marcus. Best deadlift in competitions, 375 kilos, 826 pounds.
You're pretty close.
I want to hit 300, and hopefully this is the guy to do it to me. Do it to me?
Do it to you. Yeah. Do it to you. You can do it to yourself.
Everything looks good now. So remember, as you set up, I want you to think about using your lats, tightening them to wedge yourself back at the start of the lift.
Okay.
So your lats are gonna keep the bar nice and close to your body, and that's gonna be a cue at the start of the lift to keep the bar close.
Kind of like
more
roll back.
Yep. Okay. And as you're coming up, another helpful thing is to bring your head up. Let your head kind of lead your spine to lock out.
All right, this is the first time I've ever taken this jump. This is fucking like actual crazy. 170 to 220.
What the fuck? That's tight. Big breath, come on.
Easy. Nice.
If you think you're about to like go quickly and you're gonna yank it, push it forward.
Progressive, yeah.
Remember, the lats bring you back, tighten your whole back that way, and then you initiate.
Yeah.
Use that power in your quads.
That's huge for
push.
Me.
Today. He beat Steffi by one rep. Her best is 500 for five, he did 500 for six. So,
thanks, guys.
Round of applause, guys.
We're about the same body weight, too.
Yeah,
so
yeah, yeah.
What I saw in that 500 for six,
yeah,
you're more confident, your technique was better, you weren't yanking it off the ground.
Yeah.
You used that cue we talked about, building tension through your lats and posterior chain, and every rep was really, really good. There was no lower back rounding. You weren't yanking yourself forward and out of position. So every rep was really efficient. Shit, you did four more than your best, so.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Clearly.
I'm fucking pumped, man. Now let's
try this.
Let's try this shit.
Yeah, try. So pull, push, push. That counts as one.
Okay.
While the other person does a farmer carry. So you guys can see this there, this is mine. And the other person does a front rack carry. So. My day will come, my day.